I met an old man on the path that runs above the sea. And as we passed, I saw him smile and lift his eyes to me. There was such peace upon his face, a calm and gentle ease. And pausing by a stone, he leaned his pack upon his knees. I am not as young as once I was, nor old as I will be. These legs of mine have tramped since noon. I'm tired, as you can see. We stopped to talk, and while we spoke, the light began to fail. He said, "There is a hush upon the land, as though a waking dream, like seaborne mist, has settled on these hills and all between. It takes me back to when I roamed this path, as young as you. It was a spring day, long since past, yet fresh as morning dew, the hour still glimmers in my mind with brightness of a star. For though it happened long ago, I stood where now we are. It was a time of pestilence, all empty roads and lanes, for people stayed at home all through to help it pass and wane. No sound of cars or aeroplanes or voices in the park. The towns and cities locked their doors and curfewed after dark. And from this hill I listened out, away across the fields, down to those sighing waves below and singing of the seals. A blackbird peeling in an ash behind that nearby barn. A wheatear flashed among the rocks, a stonejat in the gorse, and all the while a blackcap sang in the whitethorn by the horse. The horse's mane was winter long, and hung about its neck, like falling water from a rill that tumbles to the beck. Its brow shone white, but eyes as dark as thunderclouds at dusk. It shook its forelocks, came astride, and honored me with trust. The setting sun spent threads of gold that shimmered down its girth, its bright shod hooves pressed arcing moons into the soft brown earth. The horse and I walked side by side in silence through the firs, until our path gave out on top where now we do converse. And here upon this very spot I lay my head aside, against its shoulder warm and soft, my cheek against its hide. And in the breeze I heard its voice, like wind through ripened grain, that through the barley stalks dries off the passing lammas rain. This too shall pass, and all that now seems dark and full of dread will melt away, like winter snow gives way to spring instead. Now since that far-off time, the homes we see about us here are once more filled with voices glad and people all the year. The gardens worked, the woods are cropped for birds and timber stock, and little's bought that isn't grown not far from round the block. Was the time the world began to measure growth in annual rings of forests and of wilderness, of life and growing things, when GDP became a phrase that fell from use and habit, when well-being, health and living wage took over from the profit. The days when markets crashed and fell but rose again renewed to buy and sell fair-traded goods that ended lack of food. Beyond the suffering and the grief, the sorrows and the fears, we came out worn and sore within, but stronger than for years. For what we felt and heard and saw in living through that time of men and women, doctors, nurses, carers on front lines, made each and every one rethink the value that we'd placed upon the things most precious and the future now we faced. With every hardship comes a grace, a dawn to every night, for darkness shows the beauty of the starlight burning bright that dwells in each and every one of us and waits its turn to shine. It lives within your heart, young man, and glows yet warm in mine. The sun had set beyond the sea, the sky was molten gold. He nodded as he raised his pack, and onward down he strode. I stood upon the path a while and watched him weave his way between the yellow blossoms that were fading now to grey. He turned a corner by the stile and disappeared from sight. A horse neighed somewhere in the dark. I heard it say, "Good night."